जय श्री राम. वेलकम टू एस्ट्रोलॉजी विद अभिलाषा. टुडे आई एम टेकिंग अप सैटर्न एज तारा कारक. सो व्हाट इज तारा कारक? तारा कारक इज द प्लैनेट व्हिच हैपेंस टू बी एट द लोएस्ट डिग्री इन योर बर्थ चार्ट. सो व्हेन सैटर्न बिकम्स दिस प्लैनेट, व्हाट ऑल एट्रीब्यूट्स विल इट गिव इट टू योर स्पाउस? व्हाट ऑल यू डिजायर एंड डिमांड आउट ऑफ योर स्पाउस एंड योर मैरिटल रिलेशनशिप? दैट वुड बी गवर्न्ड बाय दिस प्लैनेट Saturn as Dharakarak. So let's think about the story of Beauty and the Beast. That is the essence of Saturn as Dharakarak. Saturn in traditional astrology is seen as the most dreaded planet. He teaches you everything. He changes you from the person you are at one point of your life to a better and much brighter person through pain and certain circumstances from which you want to just run away. So when does the beast in the story of Beast and the Beauty turns into the prince? It is the point where the princess love him selflessly and totally devoted. He can be only freed from the spell and become the prince when he is loved for the person he is. So that is the story we attach to Saturn as Dharakarak. You have to love your spouse as he or she is. Totally devoted. Now we should understand, Saturn has a way of teaching you things, and when it becomes the governing factor of your married life, it is very clear that you have a lot of karmic log in the sector, in the field of marriage, in your horoscope, because Saturn is already a very karmic planet. He is the planet who governs law and dispose of your karma as well from time to time. And what are the ways of Saturn? It is always very grilling, very, you know, hard. He is a hard taskmaster. So you evolve as a person by undergoing situations which are hard to handle. So it is for sure that you would get a partner who's a bit aloof, distant in the relationship. The whole concept of marriage would be similar for you, because you should understand that Saturn is the outermost planet in the planetary cabinet. What does it signify? That your spouse or the whole setup of marriage for you can become a bit distant, a bit aloof. You can experience something which can be termed as disinterested. But what should be your approach? Your approach should be of warmth and love. Approach your partner, approach your marriage with full warmth and love, without any expectation of receiving it back in the relation. Because understand, here you are to just live through your karma, which you have in the married field of your life. Saturn in traditional astrology is all about self-control, restraint, being tactful, being disciplined, following your traditional values. So it might happen that your partner is all about discipline, is all about following his or her traditional values to the T. and he would expect the same from you. You should understand that Saturn also rules the nakshatra of Anuradha, which is all about the story of Sri Radha and her love and devotion towards Sri Krishna. Imbibe all the good qualities from the story, from the love of Sri Radha towards Sri Krishna. That is the story of complete devotion and complete submission. You should remove all your ego clashes. Saturn here becomes your Dharakaraka to just remove every trace of ego you have in your partnerships, in your relations, in your marital situation. He is here to teach you something which will eventually make you into a better person. These circumstances which you will face will actually evolve you, prepare you for a better tomorrow. Saturn is that pressure which is required to make a coal into a diamond. And now it is by the way of your partner, it is by the way of your marriage, because Saturn is governing here your marriage, your partner. So Saturn is making your relation very karmic one. And the sooner you understand it is better. You should be very prepared that this relation will not be of equals. Do not demand equality here. Understand, to receive something, you have to give it first. That is the theme here. Your partner may be a person who always needs to strike balance into his life. Or rather, your relation would demand striking a balance in different spheres of your life. Maybe your occupation and your relation, your family, your workplace, they demand a balance from you, because Saturn is the planet which exalts in the sign of Libra, which is all about striking the balance, achieving the balance. So these are the traits which you have to work upon if Saturn has become your Dharakarak. Saturn is the least glamorous planet in the complete set of planets. He is termed as an old person who is aloof and cold. But that is a very generic view. Why do we forget that Saturn is actually the son of Lord Surya, and he is also a prince? So to transform this beast into a prince, you have to have the love and affection of Sri Radha, the devotion who is completely selfless, and eventually you will understand and you will achieve the rhythm which you need to sustain through the hard noose of Saturn. So I hope I have made myself clear. This is an excellent planet to be as your Dharakaraka, because it will eventually shape you, shape your personality as a person. So I hope you enjoy it. Take care. Jai Shri Ram. See you in another video.